student, good morning. Today we will meet the different topics related to the chapter Computer Threats and Security. In the second chapter, we have already learned about different topics covered yesterday in our last video. That was about hacking, password protection, phishing, how can the software threat, hardware threat attacks our computer system. Today we will meet some another point related to the computer threats and security. So move towards the first point, biometric authentication method. Biometric authentication method in the modern computer version, fingerprint or voice matching technologies are used to log in. These are called biometric attribute, since these attributes are unique for a person and cannot be stolen. This method after additionally security. Some unique type of password is there, type of login is there. That unique login by using inside our computer system, any other unauthorized person cannot access that type of our file or our computer or our external some application like our email ID or our social media password. Anyone can't access. At that time, some of the computer system support to that type of authentication process. For this, the different equipments are required, different type of softwares are required is there. In the last chapter, multimedia chapter, I have given one example about the voice matching technology. In that technology, I have given you the example of a cinema called the Shivaji the Boss movie. Out of the movie, there was a single shot is there, that was the person were using his laptop by opening the laptop with his voice command. At that time, after giving the voice command to the computer system, computer could able to open its drives, its folder and files in front of the person. Instead of that person, another person could not be able to use, because the password is very strictly follow the voice system. If we apply that type of system, the computer can only open by the same voice that have been stored inside it while giving the password to the laptop or the computer system. Fingerprint is there. So many people having their Aadhaar cards. So Aadhaar authentication used with the help of your fingers. There is a fingerprint on every person. Fingerprint of every person is different. So the bank account can be opened with the help of fingerprints over the fingerprint machine. The machine takes the input from the finger input from any person and can be opened the different type of data with respect to that type of fingerprint. We get the different type of materials at the different places. If we reach up to the mall, then we can just put our finger over the machine and can directly transfer our money for paying the different type of bills, or we can withdraw the amount from the bank also, or different small centers which gives us the money. We put our finger over the machines there and we can enter the data related to the account entry as per as we can get easily with the help of our finger. we can get the different type of home materials also. We eat the rice at the ration card. We also useful this system, fingerprint system. So the biometric authentication method is very important and it is unique pattern. Anyone can't use it as the misuse of the system. The another fingerprint recognition technology. This method verify the fingerprint of the person. Verify the fingerprint of the person and give access only if the fingerprint matches. A digital image of the fingerprint is taken by the fingerprint sensor and stored in the system for verification. So many companies, so many schools have given a new rule. While coming to the school or while coming to the company at the gate, they have to give their thumb impression at that machine. That machine will take the presentee of the respective type of person for storing the incoming time, and while outgoing time also can be stored inside the computer system with the help of fingerprint. The machine is thumb machine and will be useful for getting the input from the fingerprint of any person. Firstly, the fingerprints of the employees are stored inside the system in the digital manner, and the digital fingerprint whenever repeats to get input, it matches firstly and note down his name and his timing and other details inside the computer system. The another technology, voice recognition technology. Voice recognition technology, I have given an example of the movie. Similar to that, the user's voice is captured while recording and used it to verify whenever he wants to log in instead of typing the on the computer. There are different type of giving the password is there. We can use the fingerprint, we can use the voice method, voice recognition system is there. This voice recognition system is very unique because there is no the common voice is there for everyone. The different voice is available with the different peoples. So the voice recognition system is very useful in some type of companies, in some type of different field. Like the scientist can also use the voice recognition system instead of typing on the computer, because typing is generally the common fact. Type the password and type the username, it generally common. But the different technology is voice recognition technology that helps different users to be enter his voice. The voice get matches with the recorded voice. If the voice match both the system as the true voice, then also he can access the system. Otherwise, the unauthorized person cannot access the system. Only the authorized person has given the authority to access the system. Even if another person repeat the same word or phrase, the word could not get the access as the voice texture may be differ from him. Point of voice if different in the different changes stored inside the system, then the system will not be open for the person. So the voice similar whenever at the time of recording, it should be repeated whenever accessing the system. Otherwise computer will not be open or any application will not be access that type of person's voice if voice is different. But while at the time of recording, record that type of voice that every person can remember every time. Just take a bit of voice, the computer can understand very easily. Okay, we will see the next point. The name of the file is encryption. there are the two types of process, encryption and decryption is there. So firstly we will see what has written, what different type of notes is available inside your book. So we will read the first line in the encryption point. Open your next page of your textbook. This is a very sophisticated security measure used in scenarios where security measures are extreme. If there is a need of security measure in the extreme type of the field, then that time a code language is developed and transmitted to the receiver, that is called the encryption. Code language is there to giving the language with the help of the different code is encryption. To encrypt means to give the code to transfer the different type of sentences in the encryption form. Encryption means to transfer some sentence or some word in the encrypted manner. Only the system can read that type of code. The receiver needs to know how to decipher and crack the code. This process is called decryption. The encryption is the process of giving the code to any word or any character or any sentence. And the instead of that, the another system is decryption. In that system, the to remove the code, to crack the code or to decipher the code given already is the process of decryption. So the two processes is very important in the encryption. Encryption is there and decryption is there. Simply that means encryption means to giving the code language to any specific word or any specific sentence for using it as stored inside the system for recording inside the system. But decryption is to crack the code. This process is called the decryption. Hence, even if the encrypted data reaches a wrong hand, it cannot be misused unless the person knows the decryption mechanism. The person who makes the encryption type of code only has the authority to decryption of the code. He will not be able to give the different type of authority to the different people for decryption mechanism. Only the person is having the authority to encryption and decryption. If the code has given in the wrong hand, unless he don't know about the decryption, he will not be able to access the data. So encryption process is very important, that is useful to give the code to the specific word or the specific sentences. And the decryption is to remove the code, crack the code has already given. Only the person can, authorized person can give the that type of coding. The method is commonly used in defense department, internet banking and e-commerce site. This is because the data transferred over the network is highly sensitive. The example of the encryption and decryption mostly help in the different departments like banking sector and e-commerce sector. E-banking and e-commerce are very sensitive sections because there are the routine transfer of different type of lot of amount of money is there. So the encryption process should be very secured. So for that, encryption of some data, encryption of some type of information is very important at that type of places. When you read, for example, when you read balance, the data is encrypted at the original bank server and again decrypted at the destination computer, your computer, at your computer. A person trying to somehow record this information during transfer of data over the network would be able to get only the encrypted language and hence cannot make any sense of it. if any person want to get the information about his account, bank account, so that time he can only access his bank account. He can't access the bank account of another person because there is encrypted, encryption is given only for the person's account. He only knows how his password is, what is his username. Only the person can get the data, but he can't misuse that type of data while transferring the money because encryption is only at the banking section. So bank can encrypt or decrypt the document or the different type of accounts, but cannot give the authority to any person for decrypting the different type of data. So the next point we will see, antivirus software. The antivirus software is the software that can help you to remove the different type of viruses, worms or the Trojan from your system. The antivirus software made by the company is very useful for the different computers to remove the viruses. Now know how malicious software can harm our computer. Hence, in order to protect our computer from the viruses, worms, Trojans, I have already told about that. So we will see the next paragraph. Many companies like Norton and McAfee have come up with the antivirus software. In India, the Net Protector software is mostly useful in the with the different peoples. We also use the different type of software that the name of Norton Security, McAfee. So these are the different name available in the market. You can buy, you can purchase the different type of antivirus software and you can install into your own system for removing the different type of viruses. So there are some options. The user that has the following options to remove the detected software program or repair the file that are infected, delete the infected file, quarantine the infected file. In this case, the infected file is not deleted, but it will not damage the other file in the system. Only changes is applied at the required file, don't damage to the other files. Antivirus software will helpful for every computer system. We should have to store antivirus software in our computer. Firewall. Let us take the real life scenario to understand the firewall is. Imagine that you have to board a flight. What it will be process that you go through? You have to scan your baggage and go to the personal inspection at the security checkpoint. Firstly, while traveling, you have to get the checkpoint where you can check your luggage. Every passenger boarding at the flight would go through that type of process. Every passenger is need to be go through that type of process. That if the security personnel suspensions of passenger, he can restrict his entry into the file. If suspicion is occurred at that any passenger, then it will not be able to travel inside the plane or inside different type of traveling agencies. This is exactly what a firewall does. A firewall is a powerful security program that guards your computer. Firewalls is a guard for your computer system. Like that, the different type of security measures at the railway station or at the aeroplane type of department, airlines department, can follow the different type of security measures. Like that, your firewall will be helpful to your computer, as like that the passengers or suspicious passenger is traveling through the different type of traveling agencies, so that time it will be restricted for the traveling if he is suspicious person. it analyzes every network packet that come to your system and prevent unauthorized access if any other computer in the network. It restrict the other computer. So the chapter has already end and you can read the things to be learned. Okay, thank you student, we will meet in the next chapter. Read the different topics out of the chapter and read carefully. If you have some comment, then send me the comment, or whenever you will come to the school, come back with the full type of exercises. By completing all type of exercises I have taught to you. Okay student, thank you very much.